Welcome back to everybody to Let's Play Artanelico Koga. Last time, Fennel has mysteriously vanished after we found out that Saki indeed does have MPD, multiple personality disorder, or actually more appropriately for this game, multiple personae disorder. we got our faces smashed in by one, but that's okay. That's okay. We're alive. We're fine. We'll recover. We'll repair our wounded pride. But we're looking for Fennel now, and she is nowhere to be found yet. Do you know where she is, Auntie Lou? No, you don't. What do we do? I actually don't know. I'm not entirely sure. You know what, actually, I want to do? I want to buy a couple of these. For one, I think they're actually okay-ish items for right now, if we need HP recovery. And two, I'm actually relatively sure that once we do get Fennel back, we'll get a talk topic with her because we have one of those in our inventory. So, she is nowhere to be found. She's not there. She's not there. She wasn't in the inn because I checked. Is she in the dive shop? No. She's not here either. Where is this girl? Where did she go?
Everywhere, but we couldn't find her.
Did she leave town? Sorry, Tots. Please take care of Saki for a sec.
Alright.
I guess we're gonna go on a rescue mission for her. Oh, there she is. Staring at the sky.
Fennel!
Yo, what you doing all the way out here?
Hey!
Aldo!
What are you doing? We spent the whole day looking for you.
You were worried about me?
Duh. Don't just take off without telling someone.
Yeah, for fuck's sake. That'll make anybody worry.
Sir.
Huh? What did you say?
Nothing. I'm not a little girl. I can go wherever I want.
Oh my god. Yep, she is a classic tsundere type.
Why are you being so stubborn? And what were you doing here? This place isn't very safe.
I was just watching the stars in the sky.
Stars?
Uh-huh. I like to gaze at the stars. I know a little about astrology, too. You know, cartology. If you know the true name and date of birth of someone you like, you can see whether or not they're in your destiny.
Oh, really? I didn't know you had such a girly hobby.
What's that supposed to mean? I'm pretty knowledgeable about stars. For example, I know.
Huh?
Starting with the boreal star over there. Cartology readings always start there. Aldo, which month were you born?
I was born in 12th moon. Why?
12th moon. Right. They have a totally different calendar system than we do over here. I almost had to do a double take there. Because the Artanelico world has two moons, I believe.
Each month has an ancient name. 12th moon is called Suzunomiya. My birth month, 3rd moon, is called RCL.
Suzunomiya. RCL. Those are interesting words. Note them down for later, viewers.
Each reading follows a predetermined path of stars. It's based on the number of letters in your true name. The star you end up on is your destiny star. Based on the compatibility of two people's stars, you can see their fate.
I'm impressed. You do know a lot.
I've always watched stars since I was a little kid. Whenever I was sad, I would look to the stars above.
It sure is beautiful. It feels like they can make me forget all the sadness in the world.
Yeah, if only it was that easy, though.
Come back with us. We're all worried about you.
Aldo!
Huh?
That night, you were actually...
Are you talking about Soma? Who would suspect that Clastania's deadliest assassin is actually this clumsy little crybaby?
Yeah, I had a feeling, but it is true. Who would have suspected her?
Please don't tell anyone! Please, keep it a secret! I beg you!
What else are you hiding? I don't know what to believe. I don't even know who to trust. Just tell me the truth.
I was in Clastania up until a month ago.
You were in Clastania?
Clastania?
So you're Clastanian?
I don't know when it started. There's been another me inside my mind.
Wait, what?
It's the same as Saki. But then, why are you attacking us as Soma? And what's that fourth dangerous square thing?
Fourth dangerous square? Well, at least it doesn't sound like a porno this time. So, you also have multiple personas inside yourself. What are the odds that the protagonist of our story would wind up with not one, but two Ravendales with multiple personalities? What are the odds? Me no know. Well, let's just keep listening.
I don't know.
What? But you're Soma, right?
Not by choice! Who would choose to become such a monster?
Oh, geez. Well, I mean, yeah, I guess so. I've always wondered about what it's like for people who have, like, MPD, multiple personality disorder, and stuff like that.
Who would voluntarily kill people or cause trouble for you and your friends? Sometimes I can't control myself. She forces her way to the surface against my will.
Fennel.
I'm scared. I always have been. I couldn't tell my secret to anyone. There were times that I wanted to kill myself.
Whoa, geez.
I'm sorry. And now that I understand, you don't have to tell me anything more if you don't want to.
Huh?
And when you get tired of thinking all by yourself, let me know. I'll be there to watch the stars with you. So don't be scared. I won't tell anyone about it. To be honest, I was just surprised that you're from Clastania. But I won't hold it against you.
Okay, wait a minute. This is something I don't get about his personality. He's gone through his whole life, you know, living here in the Great Fang, fearing everything from the Clastanians, being terrified, absolutely despising them when we meet him, having to deal with them. And, you know, all for good reason, too. But he can then just let it slide with her. That seems too convenient for me, but, well, it's fine. It's fine. We'll live with it. It's not the most grievous sin in terms of storytelling or character development, but it just, I don't buy it, is the only thing.
Anyway, how odd. Part-time mascot girl by day, deadly assassin by night. Sounds like a popular Telemo show.
Oh, jeez.
Alto.
She's no sneeze Detective Maho, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Please, stay by my side a little longer.
Huh?
I don't want to be alone anymore. I don't want to be scared. Please, Alto, stay with me. Always.
All right. If you insist, I'll stay with you. But only as your master.
What?
What? Am I supposed to be your servant or something?
Exactly. As of today, you will be my servant until I dismiss you. You have to obey my orders.
What?
Wait! Why do I?
Yeah, why does she?
Great, it's decided.
What?
Now. Swear your loyalty to me.
What the hell, dude?
No. All right. I'll do it, okay?
Hey, that's not how you're supposed to act.
Very well, Master.
Well done. As a reward, I'll look into Soma some more.
You have got some weird kinks, man. Weird, weird kinks.
What?
Well, you don't know who the heck Soma is, or why she's inside you. I'll help you find out, when I have the time. What?
It's nothing.
You know that servant thing was just half a joke, right?
Wait, half a joke?
Half?
What do you mean half a joke?
Look, we better go back now.
Hey, Aldo?
Yeah?
Do you want to do it? Our cartology reading?
What are you talking about? You shouldn't tell your true name to anyone other than your family or life partner.
Right. Besides, unlike the view from the tower, there are a lot of hidden stars out here. It wouldn't be accurate.
Let's get back. Everyone's worried about you.
Okay. Aldo, please go on ahead. I'll be there soon. I need to calm down a bit before I face them.
Are you gonna be all right by yourself?
Uh-huh.
All right. Try not to take too long.
Yeah, we'll see you in a bit. Oh my god, what's with the servant master thing?
Life partner.
Oh, Auto, you got them ladies falling for you.
Don't you want to live?
Whoa, what? Yes, I do. Why? Whoa, who is this? Hello.
Soma!
Oh, it's you. It's the asshole. Hi.
You're falling for someone. Did you forget? You mustn't fall in love with anyone. You must be alone.
Well, now that's just rude.
Love? I'm not falling in love with anyone!
You can't hide your emotions from me. That's why I let Aoto know our true identity.
So, that was on purpose?
Exactly. I know it's shocking, but it will save all of us in the future. Otherwise, he would get hurt.
No way!
I expect Aoto to achieve many things for your sake. But if he turns out to be useless, then I'll have to do the same thing to him that I did to the others.
Why don't I like the sound of that?
Don't!
Oh dear. Okay, so there's still something wrong here. There's something horribly wrong. God damn, I feel bad for her. Holy crap. Philly! I can never tell when there's going to be voice acting or not because they're always so delayed from the start of the text box. I'm always just kind of like, eh, are they going to speak? Are they going to speak? No. No, they're not. Okay. Anyways, I'm glad you're back. You look well. So now that everyone's here, why don't we talk about what we're going to do from now on? Yes, you're going back to Blue Canyon Hamlet, right? I'll go with you. Sure, so about Saki. Can you take care of her at your clinic in the meantime, Doc? Huh? Well, of course, I'll keep examining her until you come back. Please wait, I want to go with you. Saki, you were attacked in Blue Canyon Hamlet once. What if the Klesinian army comes back? I know, but I still want to help. I couldn't stand only being protected by you. I have to help you too. Saki, and I'm frightened. I don't want to be away from you. But if they see you, we'll be screwed once we step inside the hamlet. Then, can I become another persona?
Wait, what? Oh no. I don't like that because the two options I know, they're not too, no. Just no. Just no.
Oh god damn it. Me too.
Oh, Fiddle, of course, you already accounted for.
Huh?
Well, you have to guard me along all the way, my loyal servant.
Why are you treating us so differently?
Saki's like the delicate flower that he tries to protect Fiddle. He's just like, oh yeah, you know, you were already coming. Just like, fuck you. Just like, what the hell? Oh, man. That's just funny. That's just funny.
Fiddle, join the party.
Party topic number 3, true names. Hey, why can't we tell our true names to anyone other than our family and stuff? If First of all, what are true names? Well, everyone has a true name, but only a few seem to know the meaning of their true names. The reason why you can't reveal your true names is in order to defend yourself from the Clustanians. Everyone in the world is given a true name by the Executive District, right? In reality, when you're born, they scan your mental waves so that they can locate you. What? So they're always watching us? Well, technically yes, but they aren't always watching us. God, that is like big government gone wrong. Holy shit, that's terrifying. No sense of privacy. I didn't know that was what our true names were for. Well, their original purpose was to identify people, but they can use it to pry into your personal information. Wow, Toh, I'm sorry. I asked you for your true name without knowing what it could be used for. Huh? Oh, no worries. You just wanted to do some fortune telling, right? Yeah. Well, I don't think you're dangerous or anything. First of all, you're too clumsy to report it to the Clustanians. You called me clumsy again! Hmm? If I knew your true name, I'd report you to Clustania for bullying me! I'd report you for being a jerk. Stop being a jerk! Oh, no. Alright, so on that note, we just GTFO. We just need to go back to Blue Canyon Hamlet now. I am a little worried, though. Can we actually... No, we have to take the Heaven Trail again. I'm like, can we just, like, go there immediately? Oh, no. It's you. It's Boobs McGee. The Great Fang Militia. What are they doing over there? What's that in their hands? That's a Ravatail radar. Huh? They've got to be looking for Saki. But they're depending on that device. Maybe they forgot what she looks like. Then what's the point of our decoy? They'll probably capture anyone who sets off that machine, right? Don't worry. Use this. What the hell is that? If you put this patch over your installer port, you'll stop sending Ravatailic signals. What? Really? Wow, looks like you've got something for everything. Yeah, that is pretty convenient. Well, alright, whatever. Thanks, dude. Hopefully that actually works. Hey, you, stop. It is forbidden to illegally cross into the territory of Auto? That's you, right? Hey, man, long time no see. You've been gone for a while. Do you know what's been going on since you disappeared? There's a rumor that you ran away with a Ravatail. Hey, what are you doing? We have to check him out! Is that really necessary? As you can see, there's nothing fishy about us. You never know. Just in case, I better check everyone. Fine. Yes, rub your magnifying glass all over me. I like it. No reaction. Seems like there aren't any Ravatails among you. I told you. Okay, let us through. Come on, everyone, let's go. Wait. What is it now? Do you guys still suspect us? That woman's not from our hamlet. Is she? Uh-oh. Oh, no. Auto, is she your wife that what? I hate you, game. I hate you. Huh? What the hell are you talking about? Actually, I am- Oh, no! Don't you feed into this! God damn it, we should have picked the swordswoman! What? We're engaged. We came back to have our wedding in his hometown. What the hell? No, you're throwing me under the bus. She's been a way to go, Alto. Yeah, of course. Kill me now. All right, shall we go, Alto? Gentlemen, would you please be guests at our wedding? Toodaloo. Oh my God. What did you do that for? We were fine. We were in the clear. But, Miss, Sarapatra, that was way too smooth to be an ad-lib. You? Auto's fiancé? That's not funny. Oh, that wasn't really a joke. I was able to come out again, so I want to make a lot of sweet memories with you, Auto.
Oh, Jesus. I don't know what to say about that. Neither do I.
Oh, Jesus. Did you just dropkick me? Don't take her seriously, you stupid idiot. Ooh, scary. Do you happen to fancy Auto as well? What? No, I like Tatsumi. Yeah, I only like Tatsumi. you leave me out of this? That girl has sass. But in order to attract a boy, you may need to gain a little more fruit on your chest.
Oh. Damn. Dem's fighting words.
Oh, it's awful.
I thought he was never coming back to town. Yeah, it's quite a surprise. And with the bride, Steeps will be happy to hear the news. More importantly, let's report this to them.
Wait, are you seriously going to sell him out? I can't stab him in the back.
Of course we are. Do you want all of us to be cleansed? We have families. He brought this all upon himself.
Sorry, Alto.
Oh, great. Looks like our friends are about to betray us. Well, what else is new? What else is goddamn new? Oh, jeez. How about it? Can I? Yes, I could just jump down right over here and not have to deal with the goddamn ladders. Whew, thank God for shortcuts. Thank God for shortcuts. So, yeah, I was about to say we're still probably going to have to deal with a battle or two on the way.
Let me deal with this.
Now, I'll do it.
That's easy. Ooh, level ups. Very nice. What does that make us now? Level 10. We're actually getting up there. You level up actually pretty quickly in this game, I've come to notice. Do-do-do-do-do. God, this music. This music just takes me back, man. I played this game for God knows how long back when it came out.
Don't push too hard.
You know what I just realized? We should probably be trying to use Saki. Because Saki is now, well, technically stronger than Fennel. She's got two humas, not just one. You know what? Oh! Right! It's not Saki anymore. It's Sarapatra. So, yeah. Sarapatra will be the one fighting with us for the time being. Well, maybe we'll actually get the chance to show her off in battle. I forget if this changes, like, any of her... what is it? Any of her moves, per se. Hey, what's up? Oh my god, there's so many of these things. Please make it for me. Your cordis sets are delicious. Oh, there's the one I was talking about. Ooh, that actually reminds me. I should do that image synthesis, too. It's the most popular dish at the bistro. So I need to take them on the go. Yeah, it was so tasty, I couldn't help getting one to go, too. They're best served hot. Once it's cold, it won't taste the same.
Will you make me food?
I only serve food, take orders, and clean the dining hall and kitchen. As far as food goes, I'm not that good at cooking.
But you're the mascot girl of the bistro, right? You can't even cook?
The mascot girl doesn't cook behind the scenes. She serves the customers in the dining hall. Otherwise, she couldn't be the mascot. Well, yeah, I guess that is true, but still. You'd think someone working at a bistro or a restaurant would at least know a little bit about cooking.
So, Alto, you've been talking with Saki every night lately.
What? Are you eavesdropping on us? What do you think you're doing?
Of course not.
I'm just kidding. Don't panic so much.
Yeah, I will be mean.
See, if you guys are having fun, I guess it's none of my business.
Are we that loud?
No, just, thought maybe you should let her sleep a little bit earlier.
Yeah, I don't want her to fall asleep during battle.
I'm okay with not sleeping at all if you want to talk to me. Oh, you... Jesus. That's not subtle at all.
So I have a servant. What am I supposed to do with you? Why do you even have to think about it?
Well, I've never had a servant before in my entire life. If this were my house, I could tell you to clean it.
But that's not the case, so I have nothing to make you do.
Well, that's a good point. I would be clueless too.
First of all, Fennel, what can you do for me?
Well, I can work in the bistro as his mascot girl. That's about it, I guess.
I can make you run errands, but that's it.
Alto, how was your dive into Saki? Did it go well?
Well, I guess so. Thanks to you, I sort of knew what it'd be like.
So did she talk about me at all?
Well, not really. Why?
Because when you dived into me, that was your first time, right?
You guys seem pretty close, so I thought maybe she would be mad at me about it.
Is that really something she should be mad about?
I don't know. It depends. But if I were her, I wouldn't be too fond of it.
I don't understand. Is that because I'm so inexperienced?
For a Ravitaile, it's a big deal to let someone into her cosmosphere. Maybe that's why.
So she may expect the same seriousness from the diver. I still don't quite get it. Well, I brought it up and I don't even know. So why don't we talk about something else? Well, we don't have anything else to talk about. That's fine. We can go to the next layer, so we could actually go to her level 2 Cosmosphere. At this point. So let's do some image synthesis, too. Maybe we can make some stuff. Yes, if we finally freaking can. The V-Board and Bronze Material. Or the V-Board Trick 1. They both require a V-Board. God damn it. You son of a bitch. Making me do this. Alright, fine. We will do the V-Board Trick 1 because I kind of want the super move rather than the stronger weapon. I think this will serve us better in the long run. Why don't I create a new super move? Tots, what kind of super move can you do? If I tried, I could do quite a lot. I'm pretty athletic, you know. Yeah, otherwise you wouldn't be able to V-Board so well. Yeah, that's right. V-Boarding isn't that easy. Yeah, if you want to master it, you need to train for years. But just riding one doesn't take too much athletic prowess. Finnel, just riding one is easy enough to do in your sleep, right? What's hard is turning and sliding. Huh? Oh, yeah, of course. Yeah, he still thinks you V-Board. You really screwed that, Pooch. Hey, Finnel, can you V-Board? Huh? I heard Finnel's pretty good at V-Boarding as well. Oh, wow. A little clumsy girl like you does V-Boards? That's pretty unbelievable. You said clumsy again! But when you ride a V-Board, you shouldn't wear that skirt. Well, even if I saw it, that wouldn't be an unexpected bonus or anything. Stupid Auto! You punched me. You punched me in the gut. That Fiddle's tackle is just as powerful as always. Maybe you should create a new super move like that. What, a tackle? Why would you tackle somebody? It's done. That was relatively simple, but this is it, I guess. Oh, so your new move is ready? Thanks to you and Finnel. Are you okay? Yeah. Sorry, Auto. I didn't mean to push you away that hard. Well, because of that, Datsumi came up with a new idea, so no worries. I just hope it's strong as Finnel's tackle. But my tackles aren't that strong! So what's the name of it? I don't have any ideas yet. I don't see any need for one either. What are you talking about? The name is the core of the move! But I've never done it before. I can't think of a name. Just a temporary one is fine. Here, just name it! Then I'll just call it D-Ray for now. I'm excited to see you in the next battle. Yes, so am I! We now have a super move! To execute it, HP will be expended. In addition, it has several characteristics that regular attacks don't have. To use a super move, hold down one of the directional buttons and press square. You check which buttons correspond to which skill from each character's status screen. So why don't we go take a look at that real quick. So you now have a super move, which if we go over here, you have D-Ray. So left and square. Oop. Slam the board down to attack the enemy with a shockwave. Void element damage. So name Auto. So Auto was the one who named it. What? No, Tatsumi was. Wasn't he? I don't know. I don't care. But we have it. We have D-Ray. Our very first super move, Tatsumi shall make good use of that in battle. Now we can go back to Blue Hanyan Camlet. There we go. All right, I'll go to Steep's place for now. What are you guys going to do? I'll go to the temple where I used to stay. Then why don't we spread out into two groups? Sarabacha, Finnel, and I will. I want to be alone with Auto. Well, I don't think that's going to be too safe. I don't need any company. Why are you pouting? Alright, okay. Gojo, come with me. Yes, thank you. Keep me sane. Please keep me sane. Et tu, Doc. Et tu. Et tu, Brutus. Alright, so Tatsumi and Finnel have left. That is... I vaguely remember that actually happening, so that's why I wanted to make sure I made the super move now. Before I couldn't do it beforehand. So, where do we go? Do we go back to our house? I'm curious where we're going to find, because I know we need to talk to Steeps. Steeps! He's not here. Did he go out? Alright, well, we'll have to look around town, I guess. Is there? We can't sleep. Look how huge my bed is!
Look at the size of this goddamn bed compared to me. Like, holy shit, dude. I wish I had a bed that big. My god. Oh, hello. Talk topic. About Kiraha. Sweet. That's a good find. Right outside my home. Hey, is it true that Auto's back? Yeah, and even more so, he brought back a bride. Oh no. Now the whole town's talking about it. Yo, you guys. Long time no see. Wait, what? Whoa, wait. What was that you said? The happiest man in the world? Why would you say that? Why? Just why? Congratulations. I remember when you were a little kid, but now you're getting married. Time does fly. Well, this is just... That's the beautiful bride? Bride? No. Oh, did you say beautiful bride? I feel flattered. She's an extraordinarily beautiful woman. Oh, God. Hey, what's that supposed to mean, asshole? You love me from the bottom of your heart. What? Don't joke around. Don't be shy, happy man. Damn, what a sweet wife. I feel like I lost to him as a man. Wife. Oh, no. You just looking to cause trouble, aren't you? Aren't you? Why? Why are you trying to cause me this trouble? I don't understand. I don't appreciate it either. Oh god, a group of tourists? We're not tourists! No, there's gonna be no ceremony. God damn it, Gabe! Next time on Let's Play AT Koga, will we get married? I don't know. Find out next time. This is the Musical Gamer signing off. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe. Be sure to go follow me on Twitter for news and updates, and join the Gamer Discord down below in the doobly-doo. Also, be sure to check me out on Patreon, because all proceeds shall go to mine and Sarapatra's wedding. See you guys in the next video. Catch you guys then.